नमस्कार, वेलकम यू ऑल वंस अगेन सीवाईपी प्रोग्राम. नाउ टुडे ऑनवर्ड वी विल डू सीवाईपी योग साधना प्रोग्राम फॉर नेक्स्ट 6 डेज. इन दिस प्रोग्राम वी विल प्रैक्टिस ऑल द प्रोटोकॉल विथ सिंप्लीफाइड वर्जन्स, ऑल द प्रैक्टिसेस विच वी हैव लर्न्ड इन द प्रीवियस डेज. सो वी विल डू दिस प्रैक्टिस एंड from today onward it's only the practical session. So 7 to 8:30, do the practice with us, learn the basic things, learn the small things about the CYP program and try to make yourself healthy and happy. So get ready for practical session. Sit in any comfortable posture, sukhasan, ardha padmasan, padmasan, or you can sit in Vajrasana. Adopt Gyan Mudra of both hands, tip of the thumb and index joined together, and remaining 3 fingers should be loose but together. Make it straight. Now stretch your back upward, make your back straight, make space between your stomach and chest, and transfer the upper body weight little bit towards your hip region, that so that your alignment of your back, you can feel it. Neck should be in center. This is the starting position for begin the session. We will start always the session with prayer. So get ready. Once again check your body. Now observe your breath, how you are inhaling and exhaling. If you are doing with us, be there, observe the breathing. Now slowly join your palms in Namaskar Mudra for prayer. Inhale deeply and slowly exhale. Once again, inhale deeply and start the prayer. Gently bring your arms back. In CYP program, in common yoga protocol program, we have learned the loosening practices: neck joint, shoulder joint, trunk movement, knee movement. We have included all it, ankle movement too. So after that we have learned yoga asana series, the standing asana, sitting asana series, prone series, supine series, and then we have introduced to you that pranayam practices. Before pranayam we have introduced kapalabhati kriya, and then pranayama practices, then dhyana meditation. This was the whole CYP protocol program. Now what we have to do today onwards, we have to practice each and every practice with basics things to the advanced third. Means you have to clear how you have to stand, how you have to do the all practices with care, with breathing synchronization and with simplified versions. So get ready, we will start with loosening practices. Stand at your place for loosening practices. Yes. So please stand at your place and now stand comfortably, feet apart, 2 to 4 inches. Place your hands by the side of the body. Neck should be in center. Close your eyes. Loosening practices helps to increase microcirculation, blood circulation in the body. Now, align your body and feel the entire weight of the body on the feet. Surrender yourself. Yes. You can feel your body is moving a little bit forward, backward, sideward, but be there. Try to be centralized. Observe your breath. And now, gently open your eyes. Get ready. For loosening practices, we begin with neck movements. So here we have 4 neck movements, forward, backward, side bending, side twisting and neck rotation. So let's start forward, backward. Place your hand on the waist, feet 2 inches apart and now we will start with forward, backward movement with inhalation and exhalation. Exhale. Bend your neck forward, try to touch the chin towards the chest. Feel the stretch backside of the neck region. Inhale, take your head back. This time, feel the stretch front side of the neck region. Exhale once again. Bend forward, move your head forward. Very good. Inhale, move your head backward. Again, repeat this practice. Exhale, move your head forward properly. If you have the cervical spondylitis, please avoid the forward bending of the neck. Inhale, move your head backward. Last time, stretch it properly. And exhale, slowly come to the center. After forward backward bending, we will do neck side lateral bending. Exhale, move your head and bend your head sideways, right side. Very good. Try to touch the ear to the shoulder. Don't lift the shoulders, remember that. Inhale, come to the center. Exhale and left side. If I am saying this, exhale and left side, so don't exhale first and then bend. No, with inhalation come up. You have to inhale and synchronize the movement. Inhale, come up. Yes, once again with exhalation bend your head right side. Inhale, come to the center. Exhale, left side. Eyes should be open. Balance on both feet. Inhale, come to the center. Last time, exhale, bend your head right side maximum. You can feel the stretch on the opposite side of the neck. Inhale, come to the center. Exhale, left side maximum. Usually people do the mistake, they take their head like this. So your neck bend sideways, your chin, your nose, front facing side. Inhale, come to the center. After the side lateral bending of the neck, we will do the side twisting of the neck. So get ready. Exhale, twist your neck right side, maximum. Know your capacity. If you are not able to do the chin too much twist, so you can do little bit like this. Inhale, come to the center. Exhale, take your chin towards the left side according to your capacity and try to take your chin in the line of shoulder if it's possible. Inhale, come to the center. Exhale, right side. Inhale, come to the center. Exhale, turn your head left side. Eyes should be open, looking sideways. Inhale, come to the center. Yes. And now we will do the last neck movement. Yes. Neck rotation. So if you have cervical spondylitis or vertigo related problems, so please avoid this practice. You can do the just like this or semicircle, okay? But if you are not facing like this kind of problems, you can do the neck rotation. Exhale, bend your head forward, eyes should be open. With inhalation, take your head, rotate your head back in anti-clockwise, in clockwise direction. Exhale, bring your head down. Very good. Now, inhale, rotate your head back in anti-clockwise direction. We will do one time clock and one time anti-clock. Why we can't do in the same direction 3 to 4 times? Maybe we can feel some giddiness. That's why one time clockwise and one time anti-clockwise. Repeat this practice once again with open eyes, proper placing of the hands, proper pressure on the feet. Yes. Yeah. With inhalation, take your head back. Very good. Try to look all sides. Exhale. Bring your head down. Yes. With inhalation, come to the center. Now drop your hands. Close your eyes. Yes. Feel the impact of these four loosening practices, Griva Sanchalan, Griva Shakti Vikasa Kriya, neck loosening practices, neck joint loosening practices. Feel the impact. Next practice, we move towards the shoulder movement. So get ready for shoulder movement. Inhale, raise both sideways above the head. Raise both the arms sideways above the head. Very good. Stretch, palms facing outward. Exhale, bring your head down. Inhale, raise your arms once again up. While doing this, you have to synchronize with inhalation. Exhale, bring your arms down. Some people may feel some kind of tension, heaviness on the neck region. So you have to raise your chin a little bit upward if you are facing like this. Exhale, bring your arms down. Very good. Now we move towards the neck shoulder rotation. Shoulder rotation is a simple practice of rotating the shoulder, but we will do the first simplified version. How we can do in a simplified version of the rotation of the shoulders. So look at this. Just rotate your shoulders, place your palms on the thighs. Yes. Start rotating your shoulders, lift your shoulders and rotate. Very good. 3 to 4 times. You can this practice on the chair also. If you are sitting on the chair in the office, you can rotate this. You can open your shoulders and feel the massage of the shoulders. Yes. Now reverse. Very good. Lift your shoulders, rotate it. But don't forget the synchronization of breathing. While going upward, inhale. While going downward, exhale. Now we will do the practice of shoulder rotation in the final practice, like how we are doing in the CYP program, in the final variation. Inhale, raise your arms sideways up to the shoulder level, turn your palms upward, bend your elbows and place your fingers on the respective shoulders. Yes. Now join your elbows. Now inhale, rotate your elbows in a circular manner Inhale, raise your elbows up properly. Exhale, make circle and again bring it in front of the chest. Once again rotate. While going upward, you have to inhale, exhale while going downward. Once again, last time. If you are doing only like this, so you are rotating your shoulders, but try to make it as much as possible. Take it, your elbows towards the facing of the ceiling and then rotate it. Now we will do in anti-clockwise direction, reverse manner. Exhale, downward, inhale, upward. Very good. Repeat two more times. Exhale, downward, inhale, upward. Two things you have to be remember, don't tighten the neck muscles and don't transfer the weight only on the one foot. So, be there with balance on the both feet and neck muscles should be loose and you are doing with consciously of movement. Yes, slowly bring your arms down, then feel the impact of these two practices on the shoulder joint, on the thoracic region. Yes. And the next movement, that is trunk movement. So adjust yourself. We will do two practices of trunk twisting and trunk movement here. First, forward and backward of the trunk. Open your legs 2 to 3 feet apart. Open your legs more for forward and backward bending. Yes. Inhale from the front, raise your arms upward, stretch your arms, go backward. Very good. Exhale, bend forward with straight back. Very good, very good. You can see how beautifully he is going down. Bend forward, take your hands between your feet, take your head down. Yes. You can open your legs more. Inhale, raise your arms upward once again. This helps to make your spine flexible. Go backward with inhalation. Exhale, bend forward with flow of breath. Do the movement, synchronize your movement. Once again, inhale, stretch up, go backward. Very good. Exhale, bend forward, get a good firm grip of the feet. Yes. And now with inhalation, come back, stretch your arms upward, stretch and bring your arms back. Yes. Adjust yourself, adjust your clothes, close your legs. And relax. Now, time for trunk twisting. We will do the trunk twisting, but first of all, we will do the modified version, simplified version of the trunk twisting. So, open your legs up to the shoulder level apart. Yes. Place your right hand on the left shoulder and left hand on the waist of the back side. Yes. Now, exhale, twist your body towards the left side. Twist it, twist it, twist it. You can see the lower part of the body is straight. Inhale, come to the center. Exhale, twist on the other side. So, switch your hands, place your left hand on the right shoulder and right hand back side of your waist. Twist it, try to make your lower part straight. Yes. Inhale, come to the center. So, this was the simplified version of the trunk twisting. Now, we will do the final version. Inhale, raise your both arms up to the shoulder level from the front. Exhale, twist your body towards the right side. Yes, both arms should be straight in the level of shoulders. Inhale, come back. Exhale, twist. Very good. Inhale, come to the center. Exhale, right side. Inhale, come to the center. Exhale, left side. Last time. Twist it, twist it. Inhale, come to the center. So slowly, bring your arms down and relax. Close your legs. Feel the impact of trunk movement and trunk twisting on your trunk region, on your back, on your waist region. Are you feeling of tightness or lightness? Are you feeling of heaviness or lightness in your back region? Feel it. If you are doing with us, while doing the practice, we are aware how we have to inhale and exhale, how we have to twist, how we have to final position, stable in the final position. But after finish the practice, we have to aware what is the impact of this practice. Now, get ready for the next movement, that is knee movement. Keep your legs shoulder level apart. Inhale, raise your arms up to the shoulder level once again, palms facing downward this time. Exhale, bend your knees and come to the half skirting position. Very good. Don't cross the knees to your toes. Inhale, come to the center. Once again, exhale, go down. Yes, pressure on your heels more, not on your toes. Inhale, come to the center. Yes. Last time, exhale, bend more. Yes. Your thighs should be parallel to the ground. Inhale, come to the center. This was the knee movement. We will do the simplified version too. If you are not able to go more down, so you can do just little bit bending. Once again, raise your arms upward. Just show a little bit bend. Exhale, bend. Yes. This much you can do. More if you can. Inhale, come to the center. Once again, exhale, go down little bit. Very good. Inhale, come to the center. So this you can do in the place of the final version. Bring your arms down, relax yourself. Yes. Close your legs. So these were the practices of loosening movements, loosening practices of CYP program. Now we will do the practices of standing series yogasanas, Tadasana, Vrikshasana, Padhastasana, Ardhichakrasana and Trikonasana. These five practices, five yogasanas, it is included in the standing series asanas. We will do these five practices in the final version and with simplified version. So get ready for Tadasana. Turn your side. Tadasana, it's a upstretch posture and it's very good for your alignment and it's the initial pose. So get ready for Tadasana. Stand with your feet 2 inches apart. Inhale. Raise your arms up to the shoulder level, interlock your fingers, turn out your palms with exhalation, stretch your arms upward, stretch, 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 thoracic region should be loose, don't tighten your chest region, yes, align your body, align your body, align your body. And now focus at one point, gaze at one point and raise your heels off the floor. Balance on the toes. Always remember, while doing the balancing postures, you have to give pressure on the big toe also. If you are lifting your big toes, it's not comfortable to make the balance. So get ready. Be there. Yes. Maintain the posture with normal breathing. This asana provides balance and firmness to the body. Slowly bring your heels down. Yes. Unlock your interlocked fingers. And bring your arms down from the side. This is the final version. And if you are not comfortable, if you felt ki you are not able to perform the balance, you are moving in the final version, and if you are having the pain in the shoulders, you are not able to stretch it, So what you can do, interlock your fingers in front of the chest, yes, and place the palms on your head, yes, place the palms on your head, sir, yes, align your body, yes. You can start practice from here, yes. Then stretch your arms upward, yes, stretch it, stretch it, stretch it. Then if you feel now I am able to do the upstretch also, the turn your palms, then slowly raise your heels, otherwise you can be there and make the posture in a straight line. This is also called Tadasana. It's not, if you are not able, if you are not going on the toes for the final posture, you can do this posture. Now bring your arms down from the sides, yes, and close your eyes. Now slowly turn and adjust yourself. Next posture, get ready for Vrikshasana. But Vrikshasana, we will not start with the final version, we will do with the simplified version. Vrikshasana. Usually people are not able to make balance in the Vrikshasana. They do the Vrikshasana just dropping the leg. Once again they start pick and drop, pick and drop. It's not easy. So what you can do in place of the final version, raise your arms, stretch first, yes, stretch, 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 stretch. Take your arms up, join in the Namaskar Mudra, yes, stretch it. And just bend your right foot and place your right foot on the side of the calf muscle of left leg. Yes. You can do like this. You can see this is the simplified version of the Vrikshasana. You can take your leg first or then you can raise your arms. Otherwise you can raise your arms first and then bend your leg. Focus at one point. If you are moving your eyeballs, if you are moving your focus, then it's not easy to make balance. Slowly bring your arms down, yes, and drop your leg. On the other side, we will show you how you can take the legs first and then hands, yes. Take your hands up. Usually people try to make balance in the Vrikshasana, but they are not feeling comfortable at placing the feet or foot at the inner side of the thigh. So they place the foot near the thigh, near the knee region. It's not recommendable if you are placing your foot near the knee. It creates pressure, unwanted pressure on your knee. So bring your hands down and left foot back. Yes. So get ready for the final version of the Vrikshasana. Bend your leg with exhale, yes, try to place the foot inner side of the left thigh with the heels placed as close as the perineum. You can see, if you are able to do like this, you can, otherwise you can do the simplified version. Bring your arms sideways, very good, inhale, stretch your arms, turn your palms, focus at one point, very good, give pressure on the big toe, yes, align your body. Relax your thoracic, smile on your face, keep breathing, yes, maintain the posture, inhale and exhale. Now bring your arms back from the sides and bring your right leg back. So get ready. Once again, very good. Stretch it up, yes, be there. Usually people try to find difficulty to make balance here, so just drop your leg. You can see people just drop the leg, sir, yes, and then they try to balance without dropping the hands. Once again they started the balance here, it's not able, then again they drop, again they start. Not recommendable. do the Vrikshasana like this. You can do the simplified version in place of the final version. So bring your arms down. Yes. You have seen it, how we have taught you. If you are able to do the final version, then you can, otherwise you can do the simplified. But don't drop the leg once and try to make balance again and again, again and again like this. Don't play with your legs. So get ready for next posture, Padhastasana. Yes, adjust yourself. People having severe low back pain shall avoid this practice. Yes. We will do the Padhastasana first, simplified version. So open your legs more. Yes. And stretch your arms upward from the front. Stretch it. Now exhale, bend forward. Yes. And now bend your knees. Bend forward, take your hands down. Yes. Yes. Bend your knees more. Yes. Drop your hands, drop your head. You can do this posture in this simplified version with bending knees, surrendering yourself, but make sure your back is stretched, not make hunch in your back. With inhalation, come back. Yes. Always try to take your hands closer to your ears while coming up. Now we will do the final version. Close your legs. Stretch your arms. Exhale, bend forward. With straight back. Very good, very good. Place your palms beside your feet sideways. Yes. Very good. Transfer your weight on your toes. Yes, yes, yes. You can feel the stretch in the hamstring muscles, in the calf muscles, but don't tighten the shoulders. Relax your shoulders, relax your neck joint. Try to push your head downward. Then you can feel your weight is automatically transferring on the toes. Yes. Take your head downward. Now stretch your head upward. Inhale, raise your arms. Hands and ear close together. Yes. Stretch up, stretch up, stretch up. Exhale, bring your arms down from the sides and feel the impact of Padhastasana on your back, on your breathing and on the entire body. Very good. So, get ready for the next standing posture, that is Ardha Chakrasana. When we talking about the yoga sadhana, sadhana, it means we have to sadh of that posture, that practice. We have to practice more and more. We have to connect more. We have to feel more. We have to go deeper. Then we can say that is sadhana. Not just go and come and up. That is the only physical level. You have to connect. You have to stable. You have to feel the impact of the practice after finish, then it's sadhana. So we are doing each posture like this, yoga sadhana program. So get ready for Ardha Chakrasana. First we will show, first we will do, not show. Hope you are doing with us. Open your legs up to the shoulder level apart with for simplified version of Ardha Chakrasana. Or if you find discomfort to make balance, so you can open your legs more. Yes. Place your hand on your waist, adjust yourself, adjust your clothes. Place your hand on your waist. Yes. Elbows close to each other. Yes. Now inhale, take your head back. Exhale, bend more backward, elbows close. Yes. You can do like this if you are not able to perform with the closed legs. With open eyes, inhalation and exhalation process should be continue. Don't hold your breath. Now
with inhale, come back. Slowly bring your arms down and get ready for the final version. So join your legs, or you can give 2 to 4 inches apart. Yes. Your feet should be parallel. Never make the shape like this. Now place your hands on your waist once again. Keep your elbows parallel to each other. Yes. Open your thoracic region. Now inhale. Move the head backward. Yes, properly with open eyes. Exhale, bend more backward from thoracic, then from lumbar. Elbows close, push your elbows downward, more down, more inside. Yes. Maintain the posture with normal breathing, or if I say maintain the posture with 5 to 7 breaths or 7 to 10 breaths, observe your breathing. Very good. Observe your body. How's your neck? Is it tight? If it is, so make it relax. Is it my shoulders is tightened? So make it relax. How's my elbows? Is it parallel or not? Make it parallel. Balance on the both feet. Breathing should be normal. Then you can feel the sensation of the body more. Then slowly come back with inhalation. Bring your arms down. Close your eyes. Yes. Feel the impact of this practice of Ardha Chakrasana on breathing, on your body, body, breath and mind. Each and every posture, each and every yogasana, it's very beneficial for you. If you are doing with us properly, try to connect. Try to know yourself in each and every posture, how you are doing it. Yes. So get ready for next posture, for Trikonasana. Turn your side. Yes. We will do simplified version first. In the final variation you have seen, we used to turn the right foot, then bend right side, and on the other side we turn the left foot and bend left side. But in this simplified version, we are not turning the foot. How we have to do? You can do with us, or you can just look at first. Open your legs 2 to 3 feet apart. Yes. Open your legs more. Yes. Inhale, raise your arms up to the sideways. Yes. Palms facing downwards, stretch your arms. Very good. Now exhale, bend right side slowly. Place your right hand near the knee region. If it's not comfortable, yes, be there. Yes. Now turn the right, place the right hand on your knee. Yes. And turn the left hand and take it. You can do, this is the also one variation of the Trikonasana. But if you are not able to do like this, bring your left hand back. Bring your right hand a little bit more back. Yes. Turn the palms downward. Yes. You can do like this. And slowly with inhalation come back. So you can see, we have shown you two practices of the two simplified version of the Trikonasana. One, just side lateral bending. And then if you are able to do more, so please touch your hand to the knee or shin region and take your other hand near to the ear. Align your body, thoracic region facing front side, breathe normal, slowly come back. Now bring your arms back, yes. Get ready for the final variation of the Trikonasana, final version of the Trikonasana. People having low back pain, neck pain, stiffness shall practice with care, or you can do the simplified version. Yes. Open your legs more. Get a good grip, firm grip. Inhale, raise both the arms up to the shoulder level. from the sides. Turn your palms towards the front. Turn your palms also. Yes. And exhale, bend right side. Place the right hand behind the right leg. Final variation. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Turn your head and gaze at the middle finger of the left hand. You can see the alignment. If you are not able to hold or touch the floor, so you can hold the ankles, you can touch the shin, but align your body. Breathe normally. Now with inhalation, slowly come up. Bring your right foot back. Turn your left foot towards the left side at the 90 degree angle. With exhalation, bend. Usually people bend. In place of bending, they bend forward. They are starting the forward bending. They usually drop the shoulders and they are dropping the thoracic region. It's not side lateral bending. The side lateral bending, you have to bend from the spine sideward, like my colleague is doing it. Very good. And with inhalation, slowly come back. Bring your left foot back. Bring your arms back. Yes. Bring your arms back. Close your legs together and feel the impact of Trikonasana. Yes. So you have seen, we have done the practice of the loosening practices, loosening movement, and then we have done the five yogasanas with simplified version. The whole Common Yoga Protocol, on the 21st June, we celebrate on the International Day of Yoga, we do in 45 minutes, but today we have introduced only this much of practices. We have not introduced, we have practiced only this much of practices in that much time. Now we will move towards our sitting, so prone and supine series, but today we have focused on the standing series asanas. Tomorrow we will do the focus on the sitting series asanas like this in next 6 days, but next, in the next few minutes, we will do the remaining protocol. Sit comfortably in Vishramasana. We will move towards the sitting series asanas. We will do all the postures, all the remaining things, one by one, only one time. Yes. Relax yourself. This is Vishramasana. You have to open your legs in the sitting posture. Extend your legs and open your legs, drop your toes sideways, place your hands behind the hip region, drop your head, open your thoracic. Yes. Now we move towards the Bhadrasana. First of all, come to the Dandasana. Join your legs, place your hand beside your hip region, bring your hands a little bit more back, more back, more back, hands. Hatheliyan aur piche. Now stretch your back. Legs straight, toes relaxed. Yes. You can see this is the final variation of Dandasana. Now from here we will move towards the Bhadrasana. Now bend your knees and put the soles of your feet together. Exhale, hold your toes and pull your heels towards your body. Press your knees downward. Adjust your body, adjust your posture, but remember this, if you are adjusting your body, don't give jerk. Do the movement smoothly and stretch your back slowly. Relax your shoulders, don't tighten it. You can bend your elbows and close your eyes. Observe your breathing. Maintain the posture with normal breathing. How you are inhaling and exhaling. You can see the alignment, center and sideways. This asana keeps the abdominal muscles healthy. Now slowly come back to the Vishramasana. Now we move on to Vajrasana. Fold the right leg, join your legs first, yes. Fold the right leg at the knee and place the foot under the right buttock. Similarly, folding the left leg and place the left foot under the left buttock. Place both the feet in a such a way that the big toes touching each other and position of the buttocks is in the space between the heels and the feet. Keep your hands on the respective knees. This is final posture of the Vajrasana. I request to my colleague show you from the back side how your big toes are touching each other. Usually people do the mistake, they place one foot on the other foot and they, some people overlap the toes, but touch the big toes, open your heels more so, yes, adjust your calf muscles, yes, touch the big toes, yes, you can see. This is the way to sit in the Vajrasana and keep your calf muscles sideways and get a good grip. Vajrasana, it's good for digestion and strengthen the leg nerves. Now, turn your body this side. From Vajrasana, we will do the practice of Ardha Ushtrasana. People who are not able to perform the Ushtrasana, please do the Ardha Ushtrasana. This asana is very beneficial to relieve the low back pain. So get ready for Ardha Ushtrasana. Inhale, come up to the kneeling up position. Yes, open your legs if you find discomfort to make balance. Yes. Now place your hands on the buttocks with the fingers pointing downwards. Elbows parallel to each other, upper arms parallel to each other. Yes, with inhalation, take your head back, extend your neck. With exhalation, bend more backward. Yes, give pressure on the palms. Yes, elbows parallel. Very good. Now, maintain the posture with normal breathing. Don't hold your breath. Keep breathing. You can focus at one point or you can close the eyes. You can see how the thighs parallel. How's the upper arms parallel? You can feel the opening of your thoracic region. Feel the inhalation and exhalation movement in your body. With inhalation, slowly come back and relax in Vajrasana. Yes. Now, we will perform the Ushtrasana. Once again, I will request to those people who are not able to do the Ushtrasana, they can do the Ardha Ushtrasana. So get ready for Ushtrasana, stand properly, yes, on the kneeling up position. You can make your knees apart, legs apart, yes. Usually people do the mistake or they learn this kind of variation, take the hand one by one. We will not recommend you. How you have to go in the final posture of the Ushtrasana, if you have the flexibility of the spine, you can see. Inhale, raise your head back. Take your head back with inhalation. Yes. Now, extend the hands backward and downward. Hold the heels, place them, your palms on the respective heels. Yes. Now, slowly push your hip forward. Open your thoracic region. Come to the final posture of the Ushtrasana. Very good. Maintain the posture with normal breathing. In this practice, you have to once again try to connect with yourself. Is it my shoulder is tight? Is it my knees are getting hurt? am I able to bend, push more? How's my breathing? Then slowly come back. After this, all the information, come back with inhalation. Don't come with jerk. Always remember, slowly sit in Vajrasana. Yes. Relax yourself. Observe your breathing. Observe the changes. After the backward bending, we will do the forward bending posture, that is Shashak Asana. If you are not able to perform the Shashak Asana, you can do the simplified version without opening the knees. We will focus all the simplified versions of sitting series tomorrow especially. But if you are not able to perform the today, if you are doing this practice, so you can, there is no need to open your knees, you can do the bend forward, just show once. Place your hands sideways, sir, and bend forward. Yes. Slide your hands forward. Yes. Take your hands forward. You can do like this. Yes. Drop your head. Yes. Good. You can do like this. If you are not able to spread your knees, and this is the simplified version of Saral Shashakasana. So come back and get ready for the final version. Spread your knees comfortably apart. Keep the palms between the knees. Exhale, bend forward without raising the buttocks and stretch the arms to the front. Place the arms, chin and the chest on the ground. Yes. Be there, be there. Keep the arms parallel and maintain the final position with normal breathing. This asana helps to reduce stress and anxiety. Everybody has too much stress or anxiety. So, we recommend do this posture on the regular basis. But what you have to do in this posture, just not the posture helps. You have to connect with yourself. How is your breathing? How is your body? Sthir Sukhamasana, Maharishi Patanjali said in the Patanjali Yoga Sutra, you have to know about yourself. How's your posture? Then you can say this. This asana helps to reduce stress and anxiety. Now slowly come back. Bring your knees together and come back to Vajrasana. Yes. Turn your side please for next posture. Adjust yourself. Yes. Come to the center. Next posture is Uttan Mandukasana. It means upstretch frog posture. If you are having the osteoarthritis knee, so you can avoid this practice, or before doing this practice, you can also avoid the practice of Ardhushasana, Ushasana. Don't sit in Vajrasana also. For Uttan Mandukasana, again spread the knees wide apart with the toes. Big toes touching each other. You are only spreading the knees, you are not spreading the toes. Yes, spreading the feet. Yes. Inhale, raise both the arms from the front and palms facing front side. Stretch yourself. Yes. Now exhale, fold your right arm, place the palm on the left shoulder blade, and similarly do with the left arm. Yes. Elbows be in a straight line, relax your thoracic, yeah, means where we have the upper abs, we have the 6 or 8 abs, usually people make the abs here. So relax the thoracic region, upper region here, and stretch your back, neck should be in center. Maintain the final posture with normal breathing, close your eyes, observe few breath, get relax yourself and observe your body, then breath, then sensation of the body. First of all, observe the body, is any part is tightened, if yes, so get, make it relax, and how's your breathing, and then the feel of sensations of the body. Slowly bring your arms back, yes. come to the Vajrasana. Now, with the help of hands, place your hands sideways and come to the Dandasana and relax in Vishramasana. Yes, feel the impact of Uttan Mundukasana and the sitting postures. Now, we will move towards the next posture, that is Vakrasana. Join your legs, come to the Dandasana. Now, bend the right leg and place the right foot beside the left knee. Yes. Place your right hand beside your hip region. Now, hold the arch of the right foot, take your left hand, yes, stretch your back and twist your body. Left foot should be relaxed, toes of the left foot should be relaxed. Some people do the stretch of the left foot, they can do, but we recommend just foot of the other leg should be relaxed. Now, slowly come back with inhalation, bring your left arm back. Yes, extend your right leg with exhale, relax. Now, do the practice with left side, bend the left leg, place the left foot beside the left right knee, bring the right arm around the left knee and hold the arch of the left foot. Adjust yourself, very good. Now, stretch your back with inhalation, twist your body left side. And slowly come back. Yes. Take your right hand back. And relax in Vishramasana. Vakrasana is very beneficial to make the spine flexible and helps to overcome the diabetes problem. So, now we move towards the prone postures, prone series. Lie down for Makarasana. Lie down on your abdomen with the feet comfortably apart and toes pointing sideways on your legs. Yes. Now, bend both the arms at the elbows so that the palms are resting below the face and turn your head towards left or right side. Keep the eyes closed. This is Makarasana. Yes. And surrender your body weight towards the floor. Relax yourself. Observe your body. I know it's very simplified, it's very easy pose. It doesn't mean you start roaming your mind here and there. Connect yourself. Connect with your body. Connect with your breathing. Now get ready for the next posture, that is Bhujangasana. Join your legs, stretch your arms upward, forward. Yes. Stretch your whole body. Now, exhale, place the palms just beneath the shoulders with elbows close to the body. Yes. Yes. If you are not able to do the Bhujangasana final pose, you can do the Saral Bhujangasana. Just show the demo of the Saral Bhujangasana once. Elbows on the ground, palms resting on the floor. Yes. With inhalation, raise your head up, lift up the upper body. Yes. Slide your hands forward, slide your hand forward, elbows inside. Yes. Elbows under the shoulder in a straight line. Yes. Lift it more, you can adjust your hands. Yes. This is the Saral Bhujangasana. If If you are not able to perform the Bhujangasana, yes, slowly come back. Once again, stretch your arms and get ready for Bhujangasana. Join your legs. Place your hands beside your chest region, elbows parallel to each other, chin resting on the ground. Inhale, slowly lift up the upper body up to the navel. Don't lift too much. Yes. Elbows close to the body, shoulders relax, and maintain the final posture with normal breathing. Close your eyes, or you can gaze at eyebrow center. Yes. Maintain the posture. Observe the breathing. Slowly come back. Yes, relax yourself in Makarasana. Now, we will move towards the next prone posture, that is Shalabhasana. It's a locust pose, but remember that if you are not able to perform the Shalabhasana with both legs, you can do with one leg, then with other leg, one by one. But today we will do the final pose. Join your legs, place your hand beside the thighs, palms resting on the ground. Yes. Usually people place the palms under the thighs to make support, but no. Know yourself, how's your back strength, what's your back strength, then are you able to do the Shalabhasana without taking the support of arms, then you are the final, you can say you are the patra of the Shalabhasana, you can do only then, otherwise you do with one leg. So get ready, with inhalation, raise your legs without bend your knees as much as you can. Don't hold your breath. Maintain the posture with normal breathing. Shalabhasana relieves from sciatica and the problem of backache. With exhalation, slowly come back and relax yourself in Makarasana. So, here we have finished the three series of the posture. Standing series asanas, sitting series asanas, and prone series. Now we will move toward the last series, that is supine series. We will do the few posture of the supine series today. So turn your body, lie down on your back, adjust yourself. In supine series, in common yoga protocol, we have 5 practices. First Setubandh, then second Uttanapadasana, third Ardhalasana, Pavan Muktasana, and Shavasana. But we will do these practices here. Join your legs, place your hands beside your thighs. Yes, we will do the Shalabhasana or Setubandhasana first. Sorry, bend both your knees and bring your heels towards the buttocks. Yes, hold your ankles if you can. But if you can't, place your hands beside the heels or beside the hips region. With inhalation, raise your buttocks and trunk to form a bridge. Push your lower back more up. More up. Yes. Close your eyes, knees and thighs should be parallel, it should not spread the sideways. This asana found beneficial in depression, strengthen lower back muscles and helps to improve digestion. Slowly come back and relax yourself once again in Shavasana. Yes.
Now we move towards the Uttana Padasana, the raised leg posture. Avoid this practice in case of lower back pain or abdominal hernia. You can do this practice with one by one, means one leg, then other leg. So, close your, join your legs, place your hand beside your body, beside your thighs. We will do the final version of the Uttana Padasana. Yes, get ready. It shows how your abdominal muscle has strengthened, how much you have the strength of your abdominal muscles, core muscles. So get ready to know your knowledge of the abdominal muscles. With inhalation, raise your legs without bending the knees up to the level you can see the toes. Yes, toes should be relaxed. Be there, maintain the posture with normal breathing. This asana strengthens the navel center and helps to improve the breathing capacity. Slowly bring your legs down. Yes. Relax yourself. Feel the changes in your breathing pattern. I told you this asana improves the breathing capacity also. So, you can see the changes in your breathing pattern. It helps to take a deep breath. Now, we will move towards the Ardhalasana. People having the low back pain, please do this practice with care, or you can do with the one leg, then other leg. Yes, join your legs, place your hands again beside the thighs, palms resting on the ground. Inhale, raise your legs together without bending the knees and bring them perpendicular to the ground. Yes, yes, more up, more up, more up. Yes, comfortable. Yes, be there, be there. Take your heels a little bit more down. Maintain the posture with normal breathing. You can see the alignment. If you are facing some problem, you can bend your knees, but if you are able to perform the final version, be there and enjoy the posture, not tighten your body, comfort and feel it. Maintain the posture with normal breathing. This asana is found beneficial in the management of hypertension. Slowly come back with exhalation, bring your legs down without raising your head. And relax yourself. Now, time for the next posture, Pavan Muktasana. Join your legs. Avoid this practice in case of abdominal injury, abdominal hernia and severe back pain. You can do this posture with one leg if you are not able to perform with both legs. That is Supta Pavan Muktasana or Ekpad Pavan Muktasana. But we will do the final version. After joining the legs, exhale, bend both the knees and bring them towards the chest. Very good. Toes together. Inhale, interlock the fingers and clasp the legs together below the knees. Hold the shape. We can see it is a straight line of the holding knees or below the knees, holding the shin to the navel region. Yes. Once again, exhale, raise the head up till the chin or nose close to the knees or try to touch it. Toes pointing outward. Yes. Elbows relax, shoulders relax, and be there. I can say you are enjoying it, this common yoga, yoga sadhana program. If you are doing with us, if you are watching only, maybe you feel some boredness, boredom. That's why I say do the practice with us. Slowly come back with inhalation, bring the head back and rest on the floor. Exhale, bring both the hands and legs back to the floor. Relax. Pavan Muktasana improves metabolism. Good for digestion.
Now, here we practice Shavasana. Spread the legs sideways, hands by the sides of the body and palms facing upward. Don't tighten your hands, fingers should be loose. Surrender your body weight towards the floor. Don't tighten any part of the body. Neck should be in center. First of all, adjust your body. If you feel tightness in any part of your body, just adjust it and drop it. Like if you feel the tightness in your neck, just move your neck a little bit and relax. If you are feeling tightness in the shoulders, so lift your shoulders and drop and relax. Similar with legs, similar with your back, and then fix your body movement. Stable your posture and observe your breathing, how you are inhaling, how you are exhaling. What is the impact of the breathing? Where you can feel your breath in your abdominal region, feel the movement of the abdominal and inhalation, exhalation. Constantly relax the whole body. Observe the movement of abdominal region with breath. Be there for next 1 minute. After this much of practice, we require at least a good amount of Shavasana, a good time. Yes. Then you feel refreshed, re-energized. Observe your breathing. Now take a deep long inhale from bottom to top. Exhale. Once again, inhale. Shavasana helps to relieve all kind of stress, tension and anxiety. Now slowly come back, move your fingers and toes. Get ready yourself for the next practices. So join your legs, turn your side right or left, make a pillow of right hand, turn right side, yes. Never sit immediately, always turn, breathe there, you can turn left or right, breathe 2 or 3 normal breathing and then lift, then sit, otherwise you may feel some heaviness in your head. Now with support of hand, sit at your place. Adjust yourself, get ready for Kapalabhati. Yes, Kapalabhati Kriya, it's a cleansing practice of Shatkarma. You have heard the lecture of Shatkarma, Dhoti Basti Neti Nalki Tratak Kapalabhati. So we are going to do the practice of Kapalabhati Kriya here. Sit in any meditative posture. Sukhasana, Ardha Padmasana or any meditative posture. Adopt Gyan Mudra of both hands. Keep the back and neck straight. Align your body. Close your eyes. And inhale deeply. Expel the breath with forceful contraction of the abdominal muscles. Active exhalation, passive inhalation. The process of Kapalabhati, active exhalation, passive inhalation. Don't give too much force of exhalation, don't breathe yourself, don't inhale yourself, let it happen itself. You are focusing only on exhale. So focus on your lower abdomen region. Let's begin first round of Kapalbhati Kriya of 30 strokes. Start. Kapalabhati process practice, and they are roaming their mind here and there. They do the practice with open eyes and gazing here and there. I have to open the eyes to synchronize the movement with my colleague. But if you are doing Kapalabhati at yourself, close the eyes, focus the sound of exhalation, make it rhythmic, and connect with the practice. After complete the practice, feel the impact of the practice in your head region, in your sinus region. Feel the pattern of the breathing. So this is the Kapalbhati practice, how you have to do. So get ready for the second and the last round of Kapalbhati, around 30 strokes, 1 second, 1 stroke. Exhale deeply. I have done the Kapalbhati in the standing series, standing posture. But still, I can feel the impact, feel the lightness. This is the beauty of Kapalbhati. Now we move towards the Anulom Vilom Pranayama. Keep the left hand, left palm on the left knee in Gyan Mudra. Adopt the Nasagar Mudra or Pranayama Mudra of the right hand. Keep this mudra close to your nose. Yes, bring it, this mudra close to your nose. First of all, exhale from both nostrils. Yes. Anulom Vilom Pranayama. Remember this, you are going to do the inhalation and exhalation with alternate nostril, slowly, deeply. We will do only 3 rounds here. So get ready, exhale completely and then close the right nostril with the help of thumb. Inhale slowly from bottom to top, that is a deep breathing, from bottom to top, abdominal, thoracic, then clavicular if it's possible. Then close both nostrils. Open your right nostril, exhale from top to bottom, slowly, deeply, completely exhale. Now after complete exhalation, inhale deeply from bottom to top, make it rhythmic, make it smooth, don't jerk. Complete inhalation, close both nostrils, open your left nostril, slowly, exhale from left nostril. This is the one round of Anulom Vilom Pranayama. Two more rounds in the same rhythm or make it more smooth, more slow, more rhythmic. Anulom Vilom Pranayama helps to improve concentration. It calms the mind. But usually people take tension while doing the Anulom Vilom. They make the facial muscles tighten, they pressure on the nose, they lift the elbow. Don't do, don't require. You can see how simply, how calmly he is doing it. Learn the proper technique and then connect with yourself. Then Anulom Vilom Pranayama give you more benefit. Your breathing should be 1:1. It means if you are inhaling in the 6th count or exhale till the 6th count or more than it. Try to first of all balance 1:1. Try to make the ratio, maintain the ratio. Then you can gradually increase 1:2. It means inhale 6, exhale if it's possible then 12. After finish the 2 rounds, complete, finish the 2 rounds, then bring your right hand back. Feel the impact. Yes. Now we move towards the Brahmari Pranayama. We will do the 3 rounds of Brahmari Pranayama. Check your back. Yes. Fingers relaxed. Keep your hands in Gyan Mudra, both hands. Keep your eyes closed. In this practice of Brahmari Pranayama, exhale slowly and make a deep, steady humming sound like a bee. It means you have to inhale deeply. And while doing exhalation, you should not focus on exhalation. You have to make the deep humming sound like a bee. Deep, steady and humming sound. Get ready. We will do 3 times. Inhale. Inhale. Last time, inhale. Feel the vibration, feel the impact. Now, get ready to connect with yourself more. It means time for dhyana, meditation. We have reached here after the too much practices of loosening and yogasanas and pranayama practice with including the kriya of kapalabhati. Now time for dhyana. We have all those practices we have done. Just we can say it's preparation of dhyana. It's not wrong if I say this. So adopt any meditative posture, make your back straight. Keep your eyes closed. Your arms, shoulder and neck should be relaxed. Your hands should be in Gyan Mudra. And now, after stable the body, observe your breathing, watch your breath. A few normal and natural breaths. Now, bring awareness at the eyebrow center and go deep. Go deeper with this softly and rhythmic music. Next 1 minute. Meditation is the most important component of yoga. It keeps the mind calm and quiet. Observe your breath once again to come outer world. Move your awareness to normal breathing and adopt a resolution in your mind. That sankalpa, I commit myself to always be in a balanced state of mind. I commit to the duty, my duty to self, family, at work, to society and to the world, for the promotion of health, harmony and peace at large. I commit to follow human values and work with devotion for development of the nation. Now, join your palms for Shanti Path. Inhale deeply. Auspicious. May no one suffer. Oh, peace, peace, peace. This is the meaning of prayer, of Shanti Path. Now place your palms on your eyes and slowly open your eyes. Thank you to all of you. Stay healthy and happy. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.